DraftKings Daily Fantasy NASCAR game heads to Talladega Super Speedway this weekend for the Alabama 500. This race marks the second event of the second round in the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series playoffs. The green flag flies Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m. ET on NBC. Position differential is the key scoring statistic on DraftKings this weekend. The scheduled number of laps at Talladega 188 are much lower than any 1.5-mile track or short track, so the need for dominators is almost non-existent. It is difficult to take the lead and keep it during plate races. As a result, races like these can lead to a high number of drivers leading a few laps. It will be tough to think about roster construction until the starting grid is set. That said, here are 8 drivers who historically do well in these races, courtesy frontstretch.com's Corey Brewer. If any qualify in the middle to back end of Sunday's starting lineup, they should be the first drivers added to your DraftKings contest. Elite Tier $9,500 and up: Brad Keselowski $9,800. Talladega 17 starts, 4 wins, 6 top 5s 35.3%, 10 top 10s 58.8% average finish at Talladega 14.9. Keselowski finished 7th at Talladega back in May, marking his 10th top 10 there in 17 career starts. He has 2 wins the past 3 seasons at this track and 4 wins overall. Keselowski is great at manipulating the draft in plate races and working his way to the front. While laps led is not a category to base a lineup around, Keselowski has led 16.2, 46.8, and 24.5% of all laps the past 3 Talladega events. That's a potential formula for success if he, like all other competitors, can avoid the big wrecks this place is known for. Kevin Harvick $9,700. Talladega 33 starts, 1 win, 6 top 5s 18.2%, 14 top 10s 42.4% average finish at Talladega 15.3. Harvick is an interesting study at Talladega. His career average starting position here is 21.8, which includes only 3 qualifying efforts inside the top 5. Compare that to his career average starting position on all tracks 16.0 through 604 starts. That means Harvick has been the epitome of positive position differential at this track. His average finishing position at Talladega is 15.3, paired with 14 top 10s. An expert plate racer, this veteran knows how to work his way to the front. If Harvick qualifies at, around, or worse than his career average, he will be a must-add this weekend. All-star tier $8,000 to $9,400. Dale Earnhardt Jr. $9,200. Talladega 34 starts, 6 wins, 12 top 5s 35.3%, 16 top 10s 47.1% average finish at Talladega 15.6. While other drivers may be good at working the draft, Jr. is great at it. He is actually one of the best all-time, tied for second behind his father for the most wins in Talladega history, with 6. Surprisingly, Earnhardt has never won the pole here. Unfortunately, for DraftKings purposes, NASCAR's most popular driver still starts at the front. He has started inside the top 5 in the past 4 Talladega events. Junior will be a popular pick this weekend due to the fact he is making his last start in Earnhardt country. But buyer beware, if he starts up front for the 5th race in a row, avoid rostering him. There is not enough upside over only 188 scheduled laps. Chase Elliott $9,000. Talladega 3 starts, 1 top 5 average finish at Talladega 15.7. Elliott has been fast in every start he has made on restrictor plate tracks. A great qualifier, he started on the pole at Talladega last season, as well as for the last 2 Daytona 500s. But an aggressive nature at super speedways has hurt. He wrecked out of both Daytona races last season and at Talladega earlier this year. In plate races in which Elliott has completed every lap, he has an average finish of 10.3. Yet, in races where he did not, his average finish is 30.3. That makes Elliott boom or bust this weekend, and the stakes are high. The sophomore is racing for a first career win in the hopes of continuing his playoff chances. Expect the same aggressive style we have seen in the past. Clint Bowyer $8,100. Talladega 23 starts, 2 wins, 6 top 5s 26.1%, 12 top 10s 52.2% average finish at Talladega 14.7. Bowyer has the second best average finish at Talladega among all active drivers with more than one start 14.7. He has made 23 starts here and notched 2 wins, which came back in 2010 and 2011. He also had a pair of third place finishes back in 2014. Bowyer has recorded positive position differential points at Talladega in 4 straight races. He has two top 10 finishes in that span as well. That makes the Stewart Haas Racing driver a cheaper option for the middle of a lineup if his qualifying efforts match up with your strategy. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. $8,000 Talladega 8 starts, 1 win, 3 top 5s, 5 top 10s average finish at Talladega 10.4 Stenhouse shocked the NASCAR world back in May when he held off a charging Kyle Busch to pick up his first career cup win at Talladega. More impressively, he won from the pole, which had only been done twice in the past 20 years at the track. He then won another restrictor plate race in July when taking the checkered flag in the Coke Zero 400 at Daytona. Stenhouse has a knack for the front at Talladega, earning an average finish of 10.4 through 8 starts. That ranks him first among all active drivers. He has 3 top 5 finishes, finishing outside the top 20 only once. He has also completed all 1,523 laps attempted, an impressive 8.48 on lead lap efforts at a track that'll swallow you up in a heartbeat. Stenhouse could lock himself into the next round of the playoffs with another win this weekend. Don't underestimate his ability to pull off an upset here. Bargain tier $4,500 to $7,900 Austin Dillon $7,400 Talladega 8 starts, 1 top 5, 2 top 10s average finish at Talladega 18.9 Dillon held the top mark for average finishing position at restrictor plate tracks before he wrecked at Talladega in May and then again at Daytona in July. Still, he sits in 6th with an respectable average mark of 16.9. Dillon had 5 top 10s in 7 restrictor plate races before those two DNFs. Back in 2016, Dillon finished 3rd in the first Talladega race and then followed that up with a 9th place finish. But those wrecks have dropped his salary for this race, making him more appealing given the overall resume. Pick him up. Eric Almirola $6,300 Talladega 15 starts, 1 top 5 6.7%, 3 top 10s 20% average finish at Talladega 18.7 Almirola finished 4th in the Daytona 500, and then again at Talladega back in May. That finish came just 1 week before a horrific wreck at Kansas left him sidelined for 7 races. This weekend will mark the first plate race since his return, so it will be interesting to see just how aggressive he runs in the no. 43 Ford. Almirola has not started inside the top 20 at Talladega since 2014. That makes him a bargain candidate for positive position differential on Sunday. Pre-qualifying optimal lineup example top photo by Aspink.